Makes me feel safer.
Earthquakes, plagues, and famines we're throwing at them. I'm surprised the mortals have lasted this long.
Didn't. What's this? A live one, hmm? You want to cross the Stygian River, you pay old man Charon. Once across, don't expect to ride my boat back again. What's this? A live one, hmm? You want to cross the Stygian River, you pay old man Charon. Once across, don't expect to ride my boat back again. Not my place to pass judgment, only to get you to the other shore.
Terrible things happening up above. The dead washed down like water to the river. Only some got coins to cross, though. The rest just have to wait. Living feet have stood on Charon's ferry, although all have sought favors from the Master of the Dead. You are the same as they, I guess. Lord Hades will welcome any audience, living or not, but first you must reach the gates of his house. River Styx, with hatred of wrongs, you have me to thank for your crossing. Lethe, with forever sleeping oblivion. Acheron, with the agony of loss. Cocytus, with the wailing of tears, and Phlegathon, with flames of the pyre. Cross the five rivers of Hades, cross the facets of death. I don't expect to see you return in flesh and blood, but seeing the spark of life again brings some color to this gray old man.
I feel.
I just want to feel again. Let us touch the warmth again. I can feel the warmth. Thank you.
touch of skin.
Me to hell, and now you follow to mock my spirit? I will rather squeeze in the light from your eyes!
Flesh brings his warmth to my cold halls. To what do I owe the pleasure? We cannot return your loved ones to life. It has only brought trouble in the past. Whosoever comes into our domain remains forevermore.
No, he comes to ask for the return of spring to the world above. He bears the same sadness in his soul as my mother, Demeter. Zeus has severed the links between mortal and divine. The seeds of spring are forever buried underground, regardless of my will. But perhaps it is time to relinquish my powers of renewal. It is, after all, what keeps us apart for so long, my husband. A strong sprout must break through the hard earth to see sunlight. but many more are trapped in the ground forever. Which are you, little seed?
You've returned, and with the gift of Persephone as well. I sympathize with your plight, Nicandrios, and I commend you for your courage. I do not wish to see your people die as Zeus decrees. Once before, I was nearly the cause of your extinction, and it has brought me nothing but remorse. In some small way, perhaps this will atone for my wrongdoings. With the combined strength of spring and growth, go and bring life to lands where I cannot.
Protect yourself with Olympian artisan armor. Looking for some personal protection? Can't be too safe nowadays.
The best. With all the earthquakes, plagues, and famines we're throwing at them,
bring me the proper herbs and reagents, and I'll set to work on any potion you need.
My network can get you just about anything, for a price.
Protect yourself with Olympian artisan armor.
Watch it there. Don't start trouble.
You have broken the laws of Olympus. Pay tribute or submit to the judgment of Zeus. Very wise. We'll be watching you.
Ah, the man who walks like a false god. I have seen you in the mists of prophecy. You seek salvation for your doomed homeland. I'm afraid your time basking in the sunlight is over. Father's declared that miserable place not worth the dirt it's made from. We've wasted enough sweat and tears on your mortal theatrics. The gods gift you with knowledge and civilization to free you from your savage roots. But time and time again, you've come up failing. I'm afraid the sun only shines on those who deserve it. Run along now. My music is not for your ears.
This area is for the honored guests of Apollo.
Audacity from so small a man. If it's my attention you desire, then you shall have it.
Someone in there. I am Helios. The sun was once my prized treasure, but that snake Apollo stole it from me and imprisoned me down here. He has broken my body. Never again will I stand upon the burning chariot. Apollo is a powerful god. Any who stand against him are destroyed, or worse. But I think I can help you. First, you must escape this horrible place. I know of a secret passage. Unfortunately for me, all these years, it's been under your cell, not mine. Take these, my last slivers of sunlight. It will open the wall. Excellent. Now, escape from this prison.
I see you.
Friend, you're alive. I escaped in the confusion you made, but we're not out of the woods yet. If you seek to defeat Apollo, there are ways to tilt the scales. Find the nymph Daphne in Apollo's garden. She carries a deep hatred and will help you more than I can. The fiery stallions that pull the solar chariot must be unfettered. Apollo will be weakened without his blazing war machine. Finally, Apollo's trusted lieutenants will guard him with their lives. Put an end to them before they can make such a selfless sacrifice. Go, free my precious son from that villain's grasp.
Thank you.
Destroyer has
been...
Apollo!
I see you stalking. The light reveals all.
Help! Didn't much care for those humans anyways, always urinating in my river.
warriors for the honored guests of Apollo!
Huh?
stranger. I see you bear no love for Apollo or his servants. Bah, Apollo! Even in this wooden armor, I cannot escape his lechery. When I was a naiad, he pursued me in the forest. Just before I fell prey to his lust, I prayed for mercy and was transformed into this laurel tree. Then what does he do? He tears me from the earth and plants me in his private gardens. Every day he comes to caress my branches. I am forever sick of his leering face and spidery fingers. An enemy of Apollo is clearly an ally of mine. Take this ward, an echo of Helios's brilliance. Though he may think otherwise, Apollo does not command all that is bright in this world.
Help!
Huh? I see you skulking! The light!
Aim for the other!
Radiant son of thundering Zeus, bring fire to my arrows to pierce any shield.
Right, Apollo, patron of beauty and reason, I pray to you, grant me balance in this fight.
Guests of Apollo!
Ugh! Your oracles force clear thought upon the desperate. I praise and honor you.
Have you no patience for a slow death?
I ought to flay every last one of those inept guards for letting you traipse about like that. A pity you already put them to the sword.
Well, now you have your audience with the god of the sun, the god of flawless music, the god of glorious civilization itself.
And there you slouch, a sweaty, dirty creature in the shape of a god. Uncivilized, undeserving, unenlightened. Alone in the dark.
Let me enlighten you.
Thank you.
We'll bear down on you.
Enlightened.